Hello, good afternoon. My name is Arunima Singh and I work for TSA-WCS India program. And before I start my presentation today, I would like to thank entire committee member of this symposium for giving the opportunity to present part of my research work. This study on prioritizing turtle habitats along Lower Sarju River, Uttar Pradesh, India was supported by WCS John JT Fellowship and the other organizations. This study conducted along the Lower Sarju, which originates from the Indo-Nepal border. This river flows from north to southeast direction and meet into the Ghaghra River, which is the major tributary of the Ganga. This site also identified as one of the turtle priority area by Turtle Survival Alliance in 2018. This Sarju River is the bigger habitat for the Hardala Thirchi in the world. Despite of having this Terai Arc landscape into the turtle priority area, there was limited published information available on the Chilean from this Sarju River. So this study helped in prioritizing important turtle habitat on the basis of species distribution, species relative abundance and habitat characteristics. Apart from that, I have done survey to understand anthropogenic pressure impacting the turtle species and their habitat. It was difficult to conduct boat survey in upper section of the river, so I have walked along the river about 100 kilometers because of the narrow channels and high vegetation in the upper section of the river. After that, we have used boat in lower section of the river. As part of our previous experience, we have done this survey in pre and post winter season in 2018 and 2019, because these months were found ideal to observe maximum turtle activity of the turtles. Sarju River is a small river with variety of habitats like the oxbow lakes, deep pools, narrow channels, and high vegetations. So the entire river were covered for this survey, and we have observed 205 kilometers of the river from the origin to the confluence point. The study conducted during the daytime. Apart from ocular survey, I have done the point count method to understand the distribution and abundance of the species. About 4 to 5 kilometer observation at each point of the sites found that we have observed. I have encountered 289 turtles of 9 species of freshwater. Out of 9 species, four were recorded soft-tailed turtles, which were the Chitra indica, Nelsonia hirum, Nelsonia gangetica, and Lismus punctata. Out of these four species, Chitra indica is the species which is reported as the endangered in IUCN Red List, whereas the Nelsonia gangetica and the Nelsonia hirum is reported as proposed as the endangered in IUCN Red List. Apart from soft shell, 5 hard shell turtles were encountered during the survey, which were the Ogygianus hamiltonii and Hardala thirchi, Morania petersi, Punctura tecta, and Punctura tentoria flaviventa. Out of these 5 hard-shelled turtles, the species called Geoclamis hamiltonii, which is again listed as endangered in IUCN Red List, and the Hardala is the proposed in IUCN as the endangered. With this graph, I have tried to show the distribution of the species along the survey, all across the survey points, whereas I have found the Panchura tecta was the species were highly distributed all across the river, and followed by the Lismus punctata and Hardella thurgi, whereas the species like Panchura tentoria, Morenia petersi, and Chitra indica were encountered only about one or two survey points. This graph shows the Panchura tecta, the species which were found in higher in number in compared to other species in the Sarju River. Also, there was no species evenness observed in the Sarju River. This graph shows the habitat utilization by the species at the reference of the river depth. So we have observed Nilsonia gangetica and the Nilsonia hirum, as well as the Hardella thurgi, Geoclamis hamiltoni, and Panchura tecta were the generalist species, as well whereas the Panchura tentoria, flaviventer, and Morenia petersi and Chitra indica observed as the specialist species because they were using certain depth level, certain depth of the river. Apart from that, I have observed the threats facing the Chelonian species into the Sarju River. And what I have observed, the community living along the Sarju River, most of the community people belongs to the fisherman community and they are dependent on the fishing. And we have found the fishing nets they were using are not turtle friendly, and there were lots of accidental drowning of the turtles in those nets. Apart from that, the pollution which were observed by the drainage of the sugar factory into the river, as well as the release of the religious matter into the river. These all leads to the habitat degradation of the species. What the conservation implication of this study conducted at the Sarju River? So what I have done, I have identified 9 turtle priority area on the basis of the species richness, occurrence of species and threatened species found in the Sarju River and the habitat extent. So this study will be helpful for the ongoing turtle project at the Sarju River system, which is the capture market capture study by the Turtle Survival Alliance program supported by the Delta Foundation. So this study will be expanding by using these 9 turtle priority areas. Apart from that, this study will be also helpful to regulate the recent proposed bridge construction at the Sarju River, which could be the lethal for the Chelonian species at the Sarju River, as this is very important habitat after this survey. So at the end, I would like to thank WCS, JT Fellowship, and Delta Foundation for supporting this study, Turtle Survival Alliance for all the logistical support and the financial support, Uttar Pradesh Forest Department for their support to provide the permits, as well as WCS TSA India program, as well as the Andrew Wald and Darren Redding, Shashwat Sesi, and Ishika Dubla and Shiparna Dutta. Thank you.